quiet. Please be quiet. You may frighten Kelly. Hi, Kelly.
Hi.
Hi. Where are you from, sir?
San Diego.
San Diego. Doesn't rain much in San Diego, does it, Kelly?
Not really.
No. But you came here to enjoy the show this evening, didn't you, sir?
I sure did.
It's not even raining in California, but is there a complaint you may have from your seat?
I get a few drips.
It's dripping. Yes, it's dripping on Kelly. See, it's not even raining anymore. And there's still a leak in the studio. I think we've been told, though, I found out it's a condensation leak.
Oh, okay. Well, we have a drought here, so this is good.
To make it positive. He was being positive. I think he's a plant from CBS. Yeah, now as I see you, you've got that shifty look. There's a leak in this, there's a drip in the ceiling of the studio, and it's not even raining. At what point, where are the conspiracy theorists now? Where are you, conspiracy theorists? What about, you know, I think there may be a conspiracy against Craig. Damn right there may be. Guess what else happened today? I'll tell you. I got new contact lenses. It's not the Price is Right. You didn't win a holiday. I just got new contact lenses. No, I had my eyes laser beamed like 10 years ago, and it... And then it wears off, and I can't afford to get it done again. So I got... I was on a Drew Carey show when I got them laser beamed the last time. Now I look at the laser beam bill, and I'm working here. There's a drip in the roof. I can't. I mean, really, I should, if I was following my budget, I should just go to the drugstore and buy one of them reading glasses off the thing. Which I'm getting to the age now. But I put contact lenses in, and I can see you for the first time. Undo your top button. You too, ladies. I'll be right back. Look at that, your applause died away quite naturally, as if it were real. It's stopped raining here in LA, as you can see, the roof. It is a great day for America, everybody. It's a great day. It's very, It's very sentimental day here at CBS. So on this day in 1951, I Love Lucy premiered right here on CBS. Oh, yes. Yes. That's when TV was TV before it was just a couple of douchebags and eight kids. That's when TV was TV. That was a show. Nobody died. Nobody was murdered. There were no bodily fluids anywhere. That was a great show, I Love Lucy. I know I Love Lucy and this show are very, very different, of course. One is made on a 1950s budget with cheap shits and old jokes. And a guy with a funny accent. And the other one is I Love Lucy. Now, it's not... Do you know who it's not a great day for today? Who, Craig? Tell us who, or will you? Riddle me ree. I'm trying to appear more fairy tale-ish for some reason. I tell you, it's not a great day for today is for the old folks, because today the Social Security Administration announced there'll be no cost of living increase for senior citizens. Never mind. What about? Yeah, I don't like it. This is the first time this has happened since 1975, and I, for one, am reaching a point in my life when I'm beginning to be interested in this kind of thing. Feeling things are happening in my body. If you know what I mean. Are you there, God? It's me, Craig. I think you know what I'm saying. I'm getting involved in thinking about senior citizens. I'm noticing more early bird specials wherever I walk around. I find myself watching reruns of Matlock all the time. I'm strangely attracted to Angela Lansbury. I know. Do we have a picture of Angela Lansbury? There she is. there you go. A joke as old as time itself. Now, Social Security is the government's most popular program. You know, a couple of years ago, President Bush, remember, he wanted to privatize Social Security and put all the money into the stock market. That would have worked out. That would be like hiring Michael Vick to look after your dog. That doesn't make any sense at all. Now, legally, there are three stages of aging. At 50, you can join the AARP. At 65, you start getting the Social Security checks. And at 75, you are legally allowed to slap the waitress on the ass and call her toots. You can?
I'd like an omelette with a side of your melons.
I'm getting toward this. This is coming at me. I am 47 years old. 3 years from now, I can be in the AARP. Me! Me! 8 years from now. This is true. 8 years from today, I am eligible for senior discount at IHOP. And now I can hear what you're saying. Craig, would you really suffer the indignity just to get a dollar off your pancakes? You're damn right I would. Damn right. And for $2 off, I'd gum the waitress. Actually, I'm thinking of getting a fake ID for IHOP discount before the 8 years is up. And get my hike my pants up. Really sell it that way. For now, do you know what I did? I did that and I went, you know what, this is actually comfortable. For now, you though, I just use older seniors to go in and buy the food for me. It doesn't work sometimes, you know, it's very hard for very old people to say, rooty tooty fresh and fruity. Demographically, though, the country's getting older. Bruce Springsteen, the boss, he just turned 60. I know. Pretty soon his trademark, yeah, it's going to be here. These days, he doesn't know if he's dancing in the dark or he's just got cataracts. Now, I know how he feels. A lot of people are afraid of getting older. I'm not that afraid of it. I am looking forward to it. I'm going to embrace it. I'm going to get the Terminator sunglasses that you put over your regular glasses. I'm going to get a little rascal scooter. I've already got one of those cute little things you ride up and down the stairs. He's over there. Say hi. Say hi. All right. Back upstairs. Go on, you go. That kid's acting too much. He's acting like crazy. He's overacting. What is this? He's overacting. He's showing me up. And when I get older, yeah, I'm going to get tons of plastic surgery. People are like, oh, you're not going to be like, I'm getting tons of it all in my ass. When I am finished, my ass is going to look like Bruce Jenner. You know what? I probably won't, because you don't get it. You get a little nip, you get a tuck, you get a lip fluffer before you know it, you're unrecognizable. What, remember Kenny Rogers? Remember what happened to Kenny? Man, he went a little too. Do we have a picture of Kenny today? Look at that. Know when to hold them, know when to fold them! I'm not getting any plastic surgery. I'm too old to give a crap about looking young. Every year, though, I'm older and older and older. I notice wrinkles and weird spots and wiry hairs. I look in the mirror, I think my whole body is starting to look like my balls. It's true, man. I'm turning into a giant scrotum in front of my eyes. I may have gone too far tonight. I know. I'll consult the censors and we'll be right back. We'll be right back, everybody.
A cross-dressing late-night talk show host. He's celebrated author Salman Rushdie. And he's an unknown douchebag with no sense of dignity. Can the three of them go to a party without one of them saying something stupid?
How do you know about my dildos?
I guess not. Tomorrow night, tune in to see A Party at Elton John's House on The Late Late Show.
I think, welcome back everybody, I think we could be gearing up to the most disappointing sketch in the history of network television. And if you've seen this show for any length of time, you know I'm really pushing the boat out there. But you know what? What the hell? The kids like it. Now, here's a problem. Hey, do we have time for emails? Yes, we do. I'm trying to do the emails, and I'm looking at the emails, and I've got these new contact lenses in. Oh. And the new contact lenses, I can't read. I have to put them like that far away in order to read them. And I can read them if I do that. I can kind of read them there. If I do this and look out the bottom of the contact lenses. This is from Nicole and Lander in Wyoming. Oh, right, okay. We get a lot of letters from Wyoming. Nicole said, the other day I was a bit tipsy and decided to email an ex-boyfriend. He wrote back, but he ended it with, take it easy, champ. Is it still possible to retrieve my dignity? Right up to the point you emailed me, you had a shot. This is from Vaughn in Rhinelander in Wisconsin. Wisconsin? Yeah, Wisconsin? Is that a state? Yes. It's a state that combines the beauty of Wisconsin with the narcotic effects of Vicodin. And so what you have is a beautiful state where you can get delicious cheese and solve your back pain. Anyway, Vaughn in Wisconsin says, Craig, do you let your writers do drugs at work so they are more creative? I don't let them, but I can hardly stop them. This is from Mort. Mort. This is from Mort in Valley Falls in Rhode Island. That's a tiny little state. You know how big Rhode Island is? It's about the size of a contact lens. Mort says, "Dear Craig, why are the states so much bigger on the West Coast than they are on the East Coast?" Very simple answer, because we are awesome. That doesn't make any sense at all. They're bigger here because there's nothing much going on here. I mean, like, something like 75% of the population of the U.S. live east of the Mississippi. Did you know that? So, I mean, we don't need to have a lot of different states here. We got this one state usually covers about, you know, 40 people, and I don't know. They didn't ask me. You know what? It didn't come up at the citizenship exam. this is from Danielle in Mission Viejo in California. If you don't speak Spanish, Mission Viejo means Mission Viejo. Old Mission? It means Old Mission. Old Mission, like, hey! Is that what Mission Viejo means? I'm getting a bit viejo, haven't I? I'm getting viejo. Do you know when President Obama is a year older than me, and during the campaign he looked like 15 years younger than me, and now he looks like 15 years older than me. Awesome. You wanted to be president. Keep your looks. Keep your looks by being in a small, damp, dark studio. You'll have no power at all, but you'll be adorable. This is from Danielle in Mission Viejo. I told you that. Anyway, if you don't speak Spanish... Oh, shut up. Danielle says, "I met you at the LA book signing and you spilled your coffee all over my book." Ah, yes. Breasty Danielle. I remember you now. I just thought I should tell you that people I know are jealous of me. Really? Because I spilled coffee on your book? That's not a euphemism for anything, is it? Are we out of time? I don't care. You know what? You know what? When you fix the ooh-la-la roof, then you can tell me how much time. All right? Can cable be far away? Mary Louise in Maine says, "Dear Craig, I'm a florist and I've never heard you talk about flowers on your show. Do you have a favorite flower?" Oh, knock it off. We'll take a break. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. I got the new contact lenses, and I was looking around at the studio. I thought I was, like, doing a bit, saying this place is a dump, but I'm not doing a bit. This place is truly a dump. I mean, these people are adorable and healthy and lovely, and they have fabulous teeth. I can't believe they... My next guest is in a new film. It's called Where the Wild Things Are. It's in theaters now. Take a look at this.
"I'm Ara. I put the holes in the trees. Maybe you saw those.
Come here.
Maybe not. Anyways, it's what I do. It's not really important like things that you do. Oh, and this is Judith.
You don't really need to know me. I'm kind of a downer.
King, that's not true.
Hey. Let me see your face.
Introduce me to the king if you want.
Here, let me see your face. Ooh, what's that? Don't worry. Let me see it.
Please welcome Forrest Whitaker, everybody. Forrest Whitaker.
I'm doing good.
You are doing good. You look very well. You look very healthy and fit.
I've been trying to take care of myself, you know.
There's no light on Forrest?
I don't know.
Well, that's gonna work against you, isn't it?
You want me over here?
Well,
we have a light in the other chair.
Oh, I didn't know.
That chair? So I'll sit in this chair. It was probably a bit like.
This is good. We get to be closer.
Yeah, I know. I'm terribly sorry. You're probably used to this. It's probably a bit like this at the Oscars, isn't it? Really?
They usually tell you to move over here.
I'm sorry. It's just a terrible dump, and it rained a couple of days ago, and the lights are all out because of the rain. And
oh, is this a light thing? Because of the I saw the condensation thing.
Yeah. And then the CBS put a plant in, a guy called Kelly, supposedly is a regular human, you know.
Exactly, that's what I was trying to figure
out.
Yeah,
but I think he works for CBS, and then that's it. So, how you doing, man?
I'm doing great. Yeah. What about you? You good?
Yeah, I'm all right. Apart from, you know, the job, obviously.
Exactly. Whoa, watch out. You got it, I got it.
You freaked me out.
It's just a little condensation, a little drip.
Yeah, but you freaked me out. I'm already nervous. I'm a highly strung person. Hey, the film looks good, though.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, I think it's really...
Did you put on that costume, or did you just do the voice later?
Actually, we did the voices before. We spent like a month doing all the scenes together in this like styrofoam room, like with trees for logs and bread fights. And yeah, all this, we acted out everything. Then they filmed us and showed the puppeteers, and then they started to try to get our movements and stuff.
And do you think you'll put on that big costume for the press tour and go around and talk, kind of?
I've been hoping, you know, every time I sit and I'm talking about this character, I'm expecting Ira, the real guy, to come out somewhere and grab me.
I'm very much looking forward to this movie because I love the book. I read it to my son over and over again until he's a little old for it now.
I read it to mine too.
You did?
I read it to him. Actually, it was read to me when I was a kid. It was
really?
And I've read it to all my kids ever since.
It's fine. What age are you kids now?
Well, I got 11, I got 13, 17, and 19.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. It didn't work.
I got
one, yeah.
How old is he?
8.
8, right.
Yeah. But he's too old for Where the Wild Things Are. He's into the Mythbusters now. That's where the guys are.
No, I know those guys. But no, if he likes the Mythbusters, he's going to like this.
Yeah.
Because this is really intense.
No, it's funny because the book, when you read the book, it's just like there's not that much goes on. You know, he goes to Where the Wild Things Are and he comes back. You know,
In the book. He goes up, he's made to go upstairs. He imagines that he's in this fantasy world. These wild things come. He becomes king.
Right.
He like says, "I don't want to go back home." And that's
no.
Part
and then
of
he wants to go back home, and they're like, "Oh!" And then he goes back home anyway.
Yeah,
you
but
should know the story. You're in the movie.
Exactly. Yeah. But the thing is, when he's there in our story, he gets there and he's like dealing with all them, and you watch him become king. You watch the way they live their lives, the different emotions that each one of those the wild things are very powerful.
I'm sure it can work because I went to see Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs with my son, and that book is like there's not much going on in the. I mean, it's lovely, it looks great, but it's like 20 pages. Come on, let's be honest, it's not a movie. And then you go and see it, and the movie's awesome, and it has tons of things going on. It's fantastic.
Exactly.
So it works.
Well, you're gonna love it too.
I probably will.
I mean, probably.
I do. Is it? I'm a little concerned that it might make me cry.
Could. It's very emotional.
I can't cry. I got these new contact lenses.
So what happens? You have to like put the drops in?
Yeah, you don't have contact lenses?
I don't.
Do you have perfect eyesight?
No. I just don't have the contacts. I'm always scared. I mean, you know, when I'm touching my eyes and all that, it's...
Yeah, well...
I haven't been able to get that.
Don't touch your eyes.
Well, how do you...
You get them on your pinky then. You just pop them in at the bottom and then you blink like that.
Exactly.
And you're in a whole new wonderland of...
I mean, are they colored? These aren't colored, though, so
you still
see the world the same way.
No, actually, I don't. I can see, I mean, I'm serious. I looked around the studio when I put them in. I'm like, oh, my Lord, I just cannot believe this. This is very badly
lit. Can you see that lady right there?
What, the lady in the orange top?
Yeah. Oh, well, you can see it's orange.
Yeah. That's good.
So it's working.
Yeah. did you ever work as an eye doctor?
No,
Better like this or like this?
In school, you remember the ones you hold a little thing and you look across?
Yeah, I did that today when he was fixing my eyes. The guy came up, he said, better like this and better like this. I said, it's kind of the same.
You did it today, they just gave you those?
They just give them to you now. They have them. He said, this is roughly your prescription. We'll get it figured out later, but there you go. On you go.
Rough.
Isn't that right? Wait a minute, how do you know? You don't even have contact lenses, so how do you know? You do.
I do know a little bit. No, I have some glasses. I do have some glasses. I wear them, you know, sometimes.
What, driving?
You know, when I see far away, sometimes it's good for me.
Yeah.
Like if I was trying to read that or see the gentleman back there. I can't read what it's on his shirt there with the green.
Well, let me see if I can read it. Hold on. What does it say? Fish? Oh, yeah, that band. it's a band from Vermont. They only play one song, but it lasts 3.5 hours. Am I right? Yeah. Yeah, we're kind of out of time. I'm sorry about the whole light thing.
I'm having a good time. It's good, man.
That's good.
Thanks for having me.
You want to stick around to watch the commercials with me?
That's what I was going to do.
Yeah, all right.
Which one?
I don't know. I think they'll probably be over there. Of course, Whitaker, everybody. Guests are better known as the Mythbusters. Better known than what? Better known than me. they're the Mythbusters. Their show airs Wednesdays on the Discovery Channel. This is the greatest show on television. Maybe Project Runway, maybe this. I'm not sure. They're both awesome in their own way. Although I have to say, this season of Project Runway, I'm not so sure about. But it does have Tim Gunn, so it balances out. Mythbusters, take a look at this!
Based on previous experience, the idea that a gas tank would just explode doesn't seem plausible.
So they're trying to recreate the perfect set of circumstances under which this myth could work.
Now we're going for a big boom. Ready?
I'm ready.
Flattened gas tank with actual gas in it. In 3, 2, 1. Wow. That was beautiful.
That is awesome. Please welcome Jimmy Hyneman and Adam Savage, everybody. Thank you. Welcome to the show. Thank you for coming. And as I talk to you this evening, as you answer, maybe you could switch seats into the light and then out of the light so we'll know who's talking. And everybody's Adam and Jamie, isn't it?
That's correct.
That's right. I'm a big fan of your show. I love it. I'm surprised you get away with the stuff that you get away with. How on earth do you get past the fire laws with dropping weights on a gas tanks of gas and blowing them up? How do I get me some of that?
We discovered that actually in San Francisco, so many of the things we want to do are illegal unless you actually call the fire department first and ask for their help.
Ah, I see. Get ahead of the story.
Right.
Nice.
So, while it's illegal to make any projectile shooting weapon, like a gun or anything, if you call the police and have them come and help you build it...
Hold on. Sorry. Did you hear a weird whistling? Is this studio haunted? Jamie? Are you an expert in the paranormal?
I don't think so.
No, maybe that's why I've invited you here this evening, gentlemen. We'd like to confirm the myth that this studio is haunted by the ghost of comedy. So tell me what you've been working on this season. You're both backgrounds in special effects, right?
Yes.
In the movies. And I like the bits where you always say, you know, don't try any of this at home.
I always do anyway, though. Are you both special effects background? Is that your background?
Yeah.
In movies?
Yeah, movies, commercials.
Worked on the Star Wars films, on the Matrix films.
Stop it, really?
Well, not the old ones. I was only 10, but on the new Star Wars films.
Yeah, so. I was going to say, moisturizing. Very good.
Jake, how old are you? Like, he's like 80, actually.
80 years old? Yeah. But you keep yourself young-looking using explosives. Is it possible to blow away wrinkles? Didn't you do that on the show once? You blow someone's socks off? Was that a myth?
That wasn't last night.
It was recent, yeah.
It was last week? And how did it go? I've still got it on the table. Can you blow someone's socks off?
No.
Well, what if you blow them up and their feet are in their socks?
Then their feet are mushy pulp, but I don't think that quite means that their socks are off. They're just no longer in them.
I see where you're going. The socks are still on the feet.
Right.
Yeah. You're quite strict with this stuff, really, aren't you? So what's coming up this season, then? What are you doing?
Well, we just last night we aired the duct tape special, which is one of our personal favorites. We made a sailboat out of duct tape and sailed around San Francisco Bay for about 5 hours.
Meet any nice guys? That sounds like a parade.
It was we started that episode out with Jamie strapped me to a piece of plywood with duct tape and then hung it upside down.
San Francisco's the place to be, really. Stop interrupting, Jamie. You'll get your chance. You're very quiet man. I get the idea that you're quite a quiet, quite a private individual as well. Is that true?
Yes.
Yeah. Are you contractually obliged to appear on talk shows and stuff?
No, it's actually quite fun.
Oh.
As long as I don't have to talk a lot.
So. No. This is the perfect place for you because I'm very chatty. And Adam's very chatty as well, so...
I brought a present for you.
No. Yep. Really? Yep. Is it an explosive?
It might be minorly explosive.
Really?
Yeah. Well, years ago we did an episode all about flatulence. As part of the episode, we had to figure out how to capture my flatulence. And we built this elaborate rig of a bathtub with a funnel and vacuum tubes.
One of those.
We captured a bunch of my farts, and I brought you one. It's been aged. It's about 4 years old now. And I will tell
you... I've never held another man's fart.
I will tell you that I actually donated one of these to charity for James Randi's Educational Foundation, and it netted over $3,200 at auction.
Where? Who bought that?
In Las
Germans.
Vegas.
Germans bought it, right?
So
this actually contains... is this dangerous?
I suppose if you open if you open a valve, you could light it.
It may actually be kind of like wine. You know, the older it is, the better it gets.
It's really? Is that true?
I don't know.
You can find out.
I mean, scientifically, the gas, it stays there. The properties don't change, right? The fart stays there. Methane gas stays methane gas. It's not going to turn...
It might. I know that plexiglass actually absorbs water out of the atmosphere, so the fart may have actually been absorbed into the plexiglass over all this time.
Do you recall how wet or dry the fart was when you...
Since I was in a bathtub, it was actually quite damp.
Yeah. I feel we really got into the science of the whole thing this evening, gentlemen, and I thank you. I congratulate you on your show. It truly is the most entertaining hour of television that exists for me today. Thank you so much. Adam Savage, Jenny Hyman, and everyone in the Mythbusters. My next guest is here performing her hit single, Blow Away, from her new album, A Bomb in a Birdcage. Please welcome A Fine Frenzy, everybody. A Fine Frenzy.
Blow away. What did we learn on the show tonight, Greg?
Should one man have so much power? Good night, everybody. Good night.